Hello and welcome back to part 6 of Let's Play Fable The Lost Chapters with your host as always, Madurai Bread. In between episodes, I got myself some mutton chops and the working mustache, so I think we look pretty dapper. For this episode, we're going to be doing the first, I like to say it's the first major main quest. It's the first one that leads into the first major main quest, I would say. So it itself is not huge, but it leads into something huge. I'm not going to take any boasts this time. Actually, I'll check what the boasts are, because I think there is one that's fairly easy to do. I don't want to take the Without a Scratch one, though, because I think they will break my shield. We're going to fight strong monsters. All traitors must survive. I can take that boast. All right. So our quest is to escort some traders through the Dark Woods to get over to Oakvale, or Trader's Barrow, which is right next to, or Trader's Field, rather, which is right next to Oakvale, which is the town that was burnt down while we grew up, but it got rebuilt. So I'll just skip ahead when we're there. This is our first time in the Great Wood Gorge, so I guess I'll show you guys this place. Currently, there's a bandit toll set up. I think we'll take care of that another episode, though, because I don't want this one to run on too long.
I'm afraid this path is private. It'll cost you to get through. Or we can always use your head as an ornament. Either way suits us. So, unless you're wanting to end up dead, you'll hand over your shinies.
Oh god, that's a lot.
Yeah, that's the stuff. Clear the path. This one's all paid up. Now, get animals.
Oh, I can't wait to kill these guys later and get my money back. Now, as you can see on the map there with the purple dot, there's a demon gate up ahead. Demon door, rather. This one wants you to do an act of evil in front of it, so either eat 5 crunchy chickens in front of it, which is what I'll be doing later, or you can sacrifice an innocent in front of it, which I'd rather not do. Greatwood Cullis Gate. Nothing really important here. This is mostly just a midway point for you to grab a Cullis Gate for a teleport for later quests. So once you've walked on it, it's now on your list, you can teleport to it. Also, I should probably kill these for experience. And for the combat multiplier. Luckily, using one-handed weapons, and how we've already upgraded our speed a bit, we can swing very quickly. Nope, what do you sell? Eh. I was hoping for weapons. Although, our steel longsword is pretty nice for this early on. Over there is the Rose Cottage, which is for a quest later on, but over here, we have Ripley's in the Water. Which means special things. Hopefully, silver key. Maybe a hairstyle or a tattoo. You can tell this one was meant for the normal rod. What do we get? Moonfish. It's a special kind of fish that when you eat it, it automatically becomes nighttime. I never found it all that useful, but I guess it's kind of cool to have. This demon door. He wants you to have a combat multiplier of, I think, 12 or higher. It's one of the harder ones to get, but the reward is very good. There is a quest later on, a side quest that we're going to do, that is likely going to result in us getting that. And let's just cut down these thorny bushes. So I can get the will potion and the meat. We're not going to go in the Hob Cave yet. That's for a quest later on. But here are the Dark Woods.
Thank Avo you're here! I thought we were going to die in this hellish place! We have to get to the Barrow Fields at the other end of Darkwood. You lead the way. We'll be right behind you. The sooner we put this forest behind us, the better. There are unnatural things out there.
All right, all traitors must survive. If both of them die, though, it's mission fail.
Find the Chapel of Scorm. Please the deities there, and they will lift evil into your soul.
Ah, help! Something bit me and left me for dead. Please, let me come with you.
We can't let him follow. He's infected. He'll be eating our guts before we know it.
We have sworn a traitor oath. We have to help him.
This isn't a good idea. Not a good idea at all.
I can bear well, and there won't be any trouble.
You know, you guys swore the oath. I didn't swear this oath. My job's to protect you people, and it's obviously a threat to all of us to have this guy. He's already doomed. No.
I just have to hope someone else will help me, or I won't last the day.
We're right near the entrance. Just leave.
Coming.
I hate that I get evil points for that. I made a logical decision. And that's evil, apparently, because I didn't help the doomed man. That bugs me. That's one thing I don't like about karma systems in games. It's usually very subjective.
Right behind you!
Then again, I guess morals are in general. Darkwood Marsh has a good demon door that we'll be doing later on. Balverine. These things are a bitch to fight.
We never should have come this way.
I'm putting up the shield.
It's behind you!
There it is. Get over here. They got a lot of health. They also attack very quickly. But once you have them pinned in a corner like this, there's not much they can do.
I'm right with you.
That wasn't so bad. Now, you're supposed to shoot these things with arrows. I think it's the only time you ever see them in the game. But they're basically mushroom landmines.
You could send someone else on these jobs.
You really think so? Watch out, hero! Those spores are dangerous!
Sorry, I just like their dialogue. Thunder actually works very well here. Or lightning, rather. As you can see, Xit just jumps from target to target.
He's dead.
We should be moving along now.
Okay, bottom left, why was the context menu just telling me to fart? Oh, Darkwood Lake, this is an easy place for your traitors to die.
We can get healed there.
You need to keep a very close eye on them here.
I'm sure that won't happen to us.
I just heard some bandits yelling. Whoa! Where the hell did you guys come from? Traitors, can you, like, back up a bit? Away from the men who want to kill you? Jesus. Well, they haven't taken a hit yet. I'm putting my shield up now. Now, unfortunately, the raiders will ignore you quite often to go straight for the traitors, so keep a close eye out for guys like him who try to run past. Oh god. And this is why group heal is nice. Because the traitors aren't smart enough to back away on their own.
Coming.
Okay, come on. There're gonna be more. I know it.
If I ever had kids, I'll make sure they get nice and safe.
Oh, they just spawn over here.
I need to spend some quality time with my children.
Right behind you.
Well, here they come. But they're trying to circle around. Not gonna work. Oh god. Not them.
Coming.
Good thing he got stuck on a branch.
Look, ah. It's one of those strange stones.
The one in Greatwood is just as
easy will experience. Also, as you might have seen on the map there, there was a path to the bordello that was closed up. That's another place that's only in the expansion.
Excellent. We can stay here until you're ready to move on.
He don't look like no liberator to me, I tell you.
Yep, our traitors are gonna stay here and automatically heal.
How can I help? Oh, I haven't seen you for a while.
I know. We're on our way to Barrow Field, but I'm sure I'll see you again.
So there's some loot to grab here, and it's basically like a little shop, where there's a lot of stuff to buy here, mostly like darkened armors. Also, you're allowed to break these barrels without accounting as, thievery or vandalism.
I hope there's plenty of business at Barrow.
And of course there's a game master in case you want to play Blackjack, which personally I like Blackjack a lot. But I think I'll play a lot of those games some other day, on a side quest episode. But I don't believe I have anything to buy from these guys.
We sell great clothes.
So let's just... And the steel axe that we just got, not as good as our longsword.
You think this is bad? You should have been on my last trip.
And there's the Darkwood Chapel of Scorm, if we go over to the left there. But we don't have any business there right now. Although you can get the best bow in the entire game there. We're nearing the end of the woods. There's this screen, then the next one. Oh, here's the first big bandit of the game. The big one there's got a lot of health and a lot of range on his swing. So he's a bit hard to kill for low physique characters like me. Oh, I just got to recognize status, which is the next level of renown. I probably should save that will energy for this fight. Come on! Oh! Didn't know he had a crossbow.
Ow, that's gonna hurt.
Oh, they actually didn't go straight for my traitors that time. Nope. Execution! Oh, none of them went for the traitors. Strange. I guess I can't complain. And here's one where I want physical shield. Ranged area attacks. The hobcasters are really annoying. Luckily, hobs have very low health. At least these small ones do. I believe that guy dropped a fish. Oh! He broke my shield! And yes, this is the last one. Let's eat an apple, get a tiny bit of health back. I don't believe there are any enemies in this area quite yet. So I'll show you guys the loot. It's not that hard to find.
I'm glad I have such fine companions with me.
Also, if you take that traitor with you from the beginning of the woods, no matter how fast you move, he will transform into a Balverine by this point. If you take too long, he'll transform sooner. And augmentation, you can.
It's a dead end.
He'll never get us out of here. We'll die in these woods.
It'd be nice if they shut up for my commentary. You can augment weapons, but you can never take the augmentation out. So, don't waste it on bad weapons.
And we'll be there.
God, I wish they would shut up. Oh, our first stone golem of the game. Or is this, I think it's like a mud one. Earth? Mud. I think it's mud. Now, they'll automatically stay back for this fight. This is where your dodge roll starts to come in handy. Because this guy will not move around the field, he'll only strafe. So you go behind him, you back roll out of his area of effect slam, and that's basically the tactic to beating him. Also, physical shield is nice just in case you mess up the timing on the roll, which I often do. And it's a simple little tactic, just wail on him a lot. Honestly, this is a good time to get some skill, actually. Just because you don't need to worry about him really fighting back. So you might as well use this to build up skills you're not as good in, like will or skill. So that's what I'm using this to do. This is a pretty threatening boss if you don't just stay behind him, really. Because his projectiles are very hard to dodge. But keep in mind you are invincible during a dodge roll, but you do have a second where you're not really doing anything right after it, which does leave you vulnerable. There we go. Got a ruby, which is just a good item for selling, really. Got a bunch of will experience at the end by spamming the shield.
Barrowfield! I know the way from here! Follow me!
Make sure to grab the Coliseum here. This place is essentially a big shopping area, but you'll never really go here. There's nothing important here.
Ah, there you are! We've been expecting you!
Alright. We got Trader's Feathers, which is a trophy. Got the extra gold for no one dying. A lot of gold just for taking the quest. A lot of renown, ton of experience. This is all around a very lucrative quest.
Maze seeks an audience with you again.
Excellent.
We'll find him in Oakvale Tavern. It seemed rather urgent.
So as you just heard, he's in Oakvale Tavern. But first, there's a fishing spot right here. I believe there are a few of them in this area. So let's just run around and grab those so we don't need to in the future. Now, if I remember correctly, I want to say this is going to be a hairstyle? Let's see how good my memory is. Oh, 500 gold! That's also nice. I'll need that later for you. I don't like him. You'll know what I'm talking about later. Any fishing spots? Oh, there's one. Do you have to fish that from over here? Yes, okay. There's a tattoo. I knew there was something like that around here. Let's have another few apples. I like to stock up on apples because they're dirt cheap, and it's good just to top off your health bar with. Although, unlike health potions, food heals you over time.
Hello. I remember you. We thought you died in that awful bandit raid all those years ago. So where have you been all this time? You do remember me, don't you? I was looking for Rosie, my teddy bear, just before the raid. After that day, my parents moved to Bowerstone, but I never really liked it there. Are you all right? I think I lost you there for a second. Anyway, I have to go now. But it was great to see you again. Bye!
Weird design choice to have her have a completely different hair color when she grows up. And although the game automatically walked us right into the middle of town, don't be fooled, run back to the entrance, grab the Coliseum, because you're going to be teleporting here a lot. This is a major city. And very good things to buy here, so on some upcoming episode, I'll probably be off-screening some more trading to get money to buy stuff here. This is probably my favorite town in the game. I really like this place. I think it's the music that does it for me.
Over here. Ah, there you are. I thought maybe you were getting too famous to be seen round here. I'm afraid I've heard nothing more of your sister. And there's little else I can do. There is hope yet, though. A blind seeress lives among Twinblade's bandit clan. She may be able to tell you about your sister. The seeress stands next to the bandit king himself. And it's no coincidence the bandits have been doing so well lately. Have you heard of Twinblade? He was a hero once. Yes, giant of a man. He had little patience for the guild, though. He left, and brought together a dozen bandit factions. I always suspected he was behind the attack on your home. This could be your chance for revenge. The camp can't be far from here. The village is often under attack. I've left a quest card at the guild with the details.
That's the next major quest. The first real major quest of the game, I find. I think we'll be doing that in a few episodes, because there are some side quests to do first. But real quick before I forget, two little things. First of all, your old house is for sale, so you can buy that and either live in it or rent it out for money. But back where the people were cheating, you can get a bunch of gold for free, and it doesn't count as robbery for some reason. 250 gold pieces, very nice. And also, this is the first town in the game in which you can buy a spade, and a spade is necessary for a lot of hidden treasures. So we should get one. 5,000 gold, god no. So if we just march on down here...
Oh, now! Open!
Have a good day.
That's good timing. Shops are now opening! Opening! So! The shop's now open. Oh, well that shop's now open. I think I'll just... Oh, there he is! I was about to say... Oh, he phased through solid matter. You! Sell me a spade! Thank you, that's one expensive spade.
There are more bandits around these days.
But we've got a spade now. So in the next episode, we have a lot of side quests to do around town. Probably the next two episodes will be side quests. So, until next time, have a nice day.